As the Boston Bruins arrive for a Saturday night showdown with the Maple Leafs, they continue to push through the ups and downs of the long NHL season. For David Krejci and the Bees, that means bouncing back from a disappointing loss to Vancouver against a team that has not lost a road game this season. All right, challenge accepted.
All right, bud, let's go. No cross check?
No, it's not a cross check, that's a body check.
Let's go, huh? We got a little better, I got better. I had it, me. Keep playing, huh? Let's just hang around that net. There's gonna be some loose spots.
It's a tough start, but despite being outshot by a hefty margin in period one, Boston enters the second frame with a 1-0 lead. And then, it's the David Pastrnak show.
Up top, Pastrnak, right circle, Marchand looks in, rink wide, fired, they score! That's the hat trick, throw him if you got him!
Pastrnak's third goal of the game makes it 4-1 for the Bruins. Then it's time for David Krejci and Joakim Nordstrom to put this one away for good. Five goals for Boston, plus 40 saves for Jaro Halak, equals a satisfying 5-1 win for the hometown team.
Good win all around. It's not always going to be perfect. You know, the start, they wanted to try to win the game in the first period. They played last night through a lot of net. Good for Jaro to hang in there and our D to clear some rebounds. And then we got going and, you know, we played the way we wanted, which is, you know, we were attacking, we were winning the slot battle, and I thought we were pretty good after that and deserved to win. So good for you guys, this big win against a good hockey club. So congratulations.
Hey, I'm David. What's your name?
Logan.
Ella.
David Pastrnak may have had a hat trick, and he may be the NHL's leading goal scorer, but his night's not over just yet. He has made time to give a post-game VIP tour to some special guests from Children's Hospital.
What's it like scoring three goals in one game?
It's unbelievable. Just like one of those nights when everything is perfect, you know, where it's like when you go to school and you have a test and you prepared for it.
And you ace it.
Yeah, exactly. That's the same feeling.
Did you guys enjoy the game?
Yeah.
What did you guys think about this guy?
He did so good.
Not bad, right?
Now that's what you call an all-access tour. And to cap things off, David even has some parting gifts for his young visitors.
Well, this is not mine, but it's from Box.
Thank you.
Cool. Yeah, all right?
Box gonna be mad.
Yeah, see you soon, right?
Yep,
thank
see you,
you
soon.
A hug. Can I have a hug? Thank you guys for coming.
Bye.
Bye.
All right, guys.
While good things are happening in Boston, Bruins and hockey history are being made in Toronto.
On January 18, 1958, our next inductee played his first NHL game for the Boston Bruins.
Willie O'Ree, the man who broke the NHL's color barrier with the Bruins and who has gone on to become an inspiration to generations of players and fans, is being inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame.
At the age of 14, I had set two goals for myself: play professional hockey and one day play in the National Hockey League. All I wanted was to be a hockey player. All I needed was the opportunity. To be here with you tonight is simply overwhelming. There are no words to express how humble and grateful I am to be part of the Hockey Hall of Fame. When you return to your communities, take a look around. Find a young boy or girl who needs the opportunity to play hockey and give it to them. You never know, they may make history. Thank you for this incredible evening.
The less than 24 hours after dismantling the Maple Leafs. David Pastrnak and the Bruins are back at TD Garden looking to make a clean sweep of the weekend against the Vegas Golden Knights.
Šel jsem tě viděl.
Jo, to je moje chyba, já nejsem zvyklý na centru tam ty čo.
It's 2-0 Boston after one period, but David is still a little frustrated. Not to worry though, he and his line mates have a plan to fix that.
If Krejci walks out and I feel like he's going to block my shot, I might like fake clapper him to you, eh? Ugly, but we take it, eh? Good job, Mark. Hey, all the way. Hey! He's gonna have some IQ, no?
Number 88 entered the game with the most goals in the league, and he has no intention of giving up that title tonight.
Hey, let's bury down, eh? Finish them off. Hey, let's go, yeah.
Here's Circle Crook, one-timer, fired, they score! David Pastrnak bangs it home!
Two games in two nights and two wins for Jaro Halak and your Boston Bruins, which means a happy locker room and a happy coach.
Not easy to win in this league, just beat two good teams. So good for you, obviously, Jaro, great job in there. Congratulations, Losey! Yeah. Tonight, soldiers were awesome. All right, great goal to get us going too. Dan, yeah, that line, JFK, Bjorky, D with the penalty kills, chipping in offensively. You know, that's what it takes to win in this league. Obviously, your best players need to be your best players, but your followers or your shoulders need to be there too. So good for you guys. You're awesome today. So congratulations. Yeah.
Up next, it's four games on the road. But this will not be any ordinary trip. The Bruins lose the first two games and suffer another round of serious injuries that add to an already long list. The ravaged D-Core loses Zdeno Chara and John Moore in game one versus Colorado. Then Patrice Bergeron goes down in game two against Dallas. All this adversity means the Bruins will have to rely on their remaining veterans and great goaltending, while hoping a slew of last-minute call-ups can perform. Among those call-ups is defenseman Connor Clifton, who will take the ice for his second NHL game tonight against the Arizona Coyotes.
I got Grizz.
Excited?
Really excited. We looked good up at the point there, Kruger, huh?
Good job, good talk.
Two goals in the first 3 minutes give Connor and the Bees the start they were looking for. But still a lot of hockey to be played and a lot of lessons for the rookie to absorb.
You gotta be a little careful. Let Kretsch go there.
And stay.
And you stay and you get the use the low guy, okay?
You make that early and it's flat. We're in, we're clean. Go to your backhand, a wobble.
Yeah, I think I tried.
Right?
I think I was trying to take too much ice, honestly.
It's fine, you're trying to make, like,
yeah,
trying to make a
I'm gonna play. Settle down a bit here. Nice, Jaro!
Two-one, deep into the third, and now, The Bruins must kill off a penalty in the heart-stopping final moments if they want the win.
Oh! Come on, block it! Right, Marcy! Right! Yes! Way to finish it! Yeah!
Good job, boys!
Loved our third period. You know, we were the better team. You know, they got a little antsy at the end, 6-on-4, and obviously it's going to be, but did a great job killing it. Got our clears, buzzed up ice. So I think everyone, I don't know how you guys feel, but sure feel like all, you know, all 20 guys were contributing to that third period. Did their job, their line changed, played the right way, and we ended up being the better team.
After a tough morning practice in Detroit, Michigan, defensemen Matt Grizzlick and Jeremy Lozon have worked up an appetite.
Going to this place called Coney Island. It's like famous in Detroit. Let's do it. We'll do three of everything. We'll do one chili cheese fry too.
Matt Grizzlick may be a Boston kid, but he spent 2 years in Michigan with the U.S. National Development Team. So here in Detroit, he knows exactly what you need after a hard skate. A world-class chili dog.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Kind of a spot that we would go on off days and for breakfast and stuff like that. So it's nice to be back and kind of brings back good memories for sure. That's good stuff right there. Really good.
Okay, maybe not for lunch every day, but a Coney Island dog with all the fixings as a special treat at the end of a long road trip, I'd say the boys have earned it.
Uh-oh.
And apparently, you also get a free magic trick along with your dogs and cheese fries here at Coney Island.
Wow. Very well, that's cool. That's awesome. How on earth do you do that?
A bitter cold Thanksgiving morning in Boston, Massachusetts. But that won't stop one very large pilgrim from spreading some holiday cheer.
Thank you. We are delivering 160 pies.
Happy Thanksgiving, guys. Hi, guys. How are you?
Zdeno Chara may be sidelined with a knee injury, but he can still contribute off the ice. Today, that means delivering some delicious Mike's pastry pies to shelters across the city.
40. So I'll take 39 and somebody takes one. Thank you. You got it?
Close to
my
heart.
Good man. Good man. That's it.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you. Hey guys, how are you?
The tallest guy in the building.
Hi, how are you?
Can I give you a hug?
Absolutely.
Oh my
how are you
God,
doing?
Thank you so much
no
for
problem.
This.
No, no problem.
You look a lot different without the ice skates, man.
I know, a lot shorter, huh? I don't want to drop any.
Thanks.
So
much, man.
So 1, 2, 3. Go Bruins!
After a welcome day off for the Thanksgiving holiday, Brad Marchand and the Bruins are back to work on Black Friday against the always tough Pittsburgh Penguins.
Come on, baby. Let's go.
I was trying to pick a six so you could walk and thought it kept on the ice, I would have had it. Relax there, little man. That's one for me.
You don't want to press.
You're solid.
As usual, Brad gets his shots in, verbally and physically. But halfway through the game, it's the Penguins up by one.
Keep going here, eh? It's a good hard shift. Good hits, legs, bats. Hey, good awareness there, curls. Good try, boys. Keep going. Next one's a goal. Yeah! Come on, boys, our period, let's go. We're not gonna be denied tonight. Hey, hey! I hope your pants hit a percentage, bud.
As the intensity rises, there are glittering chances at both ends. But after 60 minutes, it's still knotted at one. Time for some sudden death OT. In Toronto, Ontario, the countdown is on for the Bruins' Monday night matchup with the Maple Leafs. Recent call-up Colby Cave will be getting his third start of the season in this important Atlantic Division tilt.
How are we doing?
Good, you?
Good.
Andrew.
Colby.
Colby?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, man.
Nice to meet you, dude.
How are things going?
I can't complain.
Yeah?
Monday night in Toronto?
Yeah.
Boys, let's make some plays.
Awesome. You have a lot of time.
Huh? Oh my.
I looked up and it was just like all day.
Colby gets a couple of chances early and is playing well. So well that he gets bumped up to the first line with Brad Marchand and David Pastrnak.
Marty!
Didn't quite win the draw back hard enough, eh?
The wrong guy.
What's that?
The wrong guy.
That's it, baby! Yeah, boys!
Hey, what a job, bro. Hey, if you want to win the draw, just let me know, hey?
It's 3-2 Toronto as we enter the third. Now Colby and his new line mates looking to turn up the heat and get the equalizer.
If I give it behind the net to Marcy,
yeah.
You go to the net, I go top.
Okay.
You can run your D dive, fine, but if you end up taking it to the middle, Haynesy's out here, which he will be, five pass down to Jake and get going back for a pass.
Plenty of good opportunities for Boston, but they can't get one past Freddie Anderson. And for the first time in six games, it's a regulation loss for the Bruins. We all know David Pastrnak is a great player out on the ice, but come to find out, he's now a champion off the ice. David has won the 2018 Champion Award, which was established by Boston Children's Hospital in 2004 to honor pro athletes who enrich the lives of children.
What's up, guys?
What are we playing?
What color?
Do you know this game, four in a row? Just love putting the smile on the kids' faces, you know, since I was a kid, I was very competitive, just love to play games, and especially with the kids, you know. Oops, I gotta go this way. I'm sorry.
Strong showing from the Bruins here tonight, including past recipients Patrice Bergeron and Zdeno Chara. Though not sure either of those guys have 88 Jenga skills.
What do we do now?
This is the bottom one.
Oh, if we take this one, then don't do it.
Or that one. Nice. That's okay. Who did that?
Daddy.
Who did that? Raise your hand.
So congratulations for a job well done. It's an important and meaningful award and a true indicator of the man David Pastrnak has become here in Boston.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Awesome, guys.
The old saying is, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. The Boston Bruins are living that saying. Injuries to a number of the team's core players, including Zdeno Chara and Patrice Bergeron, have left the club's roster depleted from top to bottom. But the shorthanded Bees keep grinding out wins with effort, determination, and exceptional goaltending. These Bees are proving tough, and the tough are definitely going.